and stop them. How to attack the enemy of your shining star and stop them. There is a way you can stop the enemy that is attacking your star. Some of you, you have stars. You have shining star, but the enemy, they attack your star until you become nothing. When you were born, they saw your star and they go for it to destroy it. And they have destroyed. Some of you, you are so anointed, but the enemy knows that you were born anointed. You were born a star. You were born mountain moving. But now, because of that, they will try to destroy your star and make everything to see that you have failed. So the Bible says we are not ignorant to the schemes of the enemy. We are not ignorant. The Bible says 2 Corinthians 2, verse 11. We are not ignorant for the devices of the enemies. The devices of enemies. We are not ignorant. The schemes of the enemies. People of God, you still you have time. You can claim your star. Wherever it is, what the enemy has done to your star, you have chances to claim your star. In Jesus' name, you have chances to command the witches and wizards, to command the enemies, the powers of your father's house that is holding your star from signing. Let them die in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Matthew 2, verse 2, where is he who has born of the king of the Jews? For we have saw his star in the east and have come to worship him. You know, the enemy is asking, where is that? Where is that born? They will see. The topic is how to attack the enemy of your shining star. Yes. Now the enemy is asking, where is he who has been born? The enemy, they are asking where. Because all the witches in your village where you are born, even if you are born here in Canada, even if you are born here in America, wherever a country you are born, the star, the witches, the wicked, the evil people will see your star. In their coven, in their country, in their place, they will see a star. When they see your star, they will make sure what to do. They can go to the hospital where you are born to make sure that they are damaged your star using your placenta. They will buy the placenta. They will make sure they have got hold of your placenta to destroy you. They know how to get your placenta. So the smart people, the smart parents, they know to rescue the star of their children. Now, nevertheless, your star has been damaged. What can you do? What are you going to do? You have to fight and claim your star back. Whoever has attacked your star, let them die. You know the enemy who was attacking the star of Jesus, he died, and then Jesus came back. You see, and then the Bible says, he was lying. He was saying that we want to worship him. But he wanted to kill him. People can come during child ceremony or christen, and they are not coming because of christen of the child. It is because they want to destroy the life of that child. One person told me his son was a star, he was born a star and he was known as star. And then this witch, they were waiting the day of christen. Now, when that time came, they went and used the pastor. The pastor called the child and put the child on the pulpit and started talking about the child and talking about the child. And then he ended up saying, I am not prophesizing. I am saying that these things will happen to you. I'm just talking. You know, he revised it and destroyed the life of the child. I was in the church here in Toronto. And then there was children blessing. And then the parents brought children for them to be blessed. One of the women who is spiritual and is very spiritual woman, is known and is very respected woman in the spiritual. this woman, when she held that child, I was very curious, looking and see what is going to happen. How, if they have really heart of God to bless those children. One of the child was a star, and this child was really a child who was born with a gift. That woman held the child and speak the word, and then in reverse, she reversed every word that is spoke over the child. And they say that this word that I've spoke, it is not going to prosper in your life. It is not going to work on your life so that you can come and say, I said. Yeah? You see, the enemy went straight and used that woman. So the owner of the child, maybe she doesn't know. She has no, she doesn't have clue. She doesn't know why the woman reversed everything she said. Because she saw that this star, the child is going to be big. She's going to be a grow and become a star. So they want to damage the star of that child before the child will grow. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus, any enemy attacking your star, attacking the star of your child, your children, let them die, let them be destroyed, let them be rendered powerless in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's look in the scripture, the book of Matthew 2, verse 9 and 10. The book of Matthew 2, chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. Those people are asking me question, which scripture? You can reverse, you can look, you can go back and check the scripture. I said Matthew 2, verse 2. Now I'm going to read Matthew 2, verse 9 to 10. The Bible says, after hearing the king, they went their way, and the star which they had seen in the east went on before them until it came and stood over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoice exceedingly with the great joy. You know, the star, it will around, it, they followed the star until where the child was, and then the star stopped. You know, that is powerful how the star is. And then these people, they were so happy, they rejoiced, and they didn't go the way that Herod wanted them to go, because God wanted them. God wants them that don't touch this child. If you touch this child, you will die. And then the person who wanted to kill that child, he died. And then the child returned back to return back home. I pray that every enemy of your star, let them die in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. He's King of Kings and King of Glory. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes. Let's look in the book of Numbers 24, verse 17. The book of Numbers 24, verse 17. I see him, but not now. I behold him, but not near. A star shall come forth from Jacob. A spark shall rise from Israel, and shall cross through the head of Moab, and tear down all the sons of Seth. Here, the star is coming. It is coming to crush the head of Moab and tear down the sons of Seth. You know, this star, it is the star that will come and destroy every works of the enemy, every powers of the devil. Jesus, his work is, he came to destroy the works of the enemy. The star of Jesus was this. That's why he was a star. He was a star because he was going to destroy the works of the enemy. He was going to destroy powers and rulers of darkness. He was going to arrest the devil and take the key and go. That's why he was. That's why the king was afraid of him. He was not coming to overthrow the king. He was not interested to be a king of Israel. His interest was he came to destroy the works of the enemy. Now the Bible is confirming here that the star that will come from Jacob is the star that will tear down and crush out the head of the enemy, Moab. Now, if you see the Bible is talking here in the book of Revelation 22:16, I, Jesus, have sent my angels to testify to you these things to the churches. To the churches, I am the root of the descendant of David and the bright morning star. Jesus is called bright morning star. is a morning star. That's why morning star, even Roosevelt was a morning star. Roosevelt was a morning star. Roosevelt was next to God, and he was a choir master. He was singing. He was having everything in heaven, and he was beautiful. He was very beautiful. He was called morning star. Now Jesus is a morning star. Is a morning star. He is the root of the standard of David, the bright morning star. Because a star is a star. You have seen even movie a star. You have seen stars, what they do. Yeah. We pray that God Almighty, that enemy attacking your star, let them die from the root in Jesus' name. I plead the blood of Jesus over your star in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 14. Verse 12 to 12, Isaiah 14, verse 12 to 13. The Bible says, how you have fallen from heaven, O star of the morning, son of the dew, you have been cut down to the heart, who have wakened the nations. But you said in your heart, I will ascend to heaven, I will rest my throne above the star of God, and I will sit on the mount of assembly in the recesses of the north. Now, here, Isaiah is identifying the devil Satan, who is called as a star of the morning. You know, Isaiah is the one who prophesies about Jesus. He is prophesies how Jesus is going to be born. And they saw the star of the morning also has fallen down. And Isaiah saw Lucifer, Satan has fallen down, and he was afraid. He was saying, this, the devil, Lucifer has fallen down, and the star is going to be born. How is it going to work? But God has planned. God has to protect Jesus, because already the Lucifer, the star morning has already fallen down, has already fallen in the heart. So his work was going to destroy the work of God, was going to destroy everything that God is doing, and deceive people and destroy their stars. That is up to today, is continue destroying the stars of the people. And because himself, he was a star of the morning. Now he knows how the star is, how the importance of the stars. So he doesn't want anybody to be a star. That's why he's a great enemy of anyone who is coming as a star. He wanted to kill Jesus at any event. The day Jesus was born like this, he wanted to kill him. He tried using a rod. He tried to use every method to kill Jesus. But Jesus did not die during the time of any event. He went as far as waiting him, and all in all, he plans the all to kill Jesus. But killing Jesus was benefit for us, so that we can be set free, so that we can be saved. But he didn't know. His idea was that to destroy the star of Jesus completely from the heart, so that Jesus cannot do the work that God has ordained him, God has told him to do. The devil is a liar. So he would try everything. He would try every way to silence your star, to stop your star from shining, from shining. Therefore, I pray every witchcraft, anyone that is attacking your star, let them die in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. My Father, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name, God. I give you all the glory, Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I bless your name, God. You are a wonderful God. And the book of 2 Peter 1:19, the Bible says, so we have the prophetic word made more sure, to which you do well to pay attention to the lamp shining in a dark place until the day dews and the morning star arise in your heart. In the mighty name of Jesus, I prophesy to you, any enemy that has attacked your star from signing, it shall be signing in Jesus' name. It will be signing in the name of Jesus. It shall be signed by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, I want to thank God that God will shine your star again, the star of your children, the star that has been attacked. God will make make the star to shine in Jesus' name. Do you know that you are created as a star in order to specially to shine? And this is the reason you might be experiencing terrible challenges and crises and crises and crises. Do you know? Do you know you were created as a star? Do you know you were born as a star? That's why you are experiencing terrible attack. You are experiencing a lot of attacks. Therefore, I come against that attack. I come against every attack. That is your attack. You are being attacked because of your star. Let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. This is the reason the devil not hold his hands and watch you, because he knows that God has a big plan for you. People with the shining star, God has a big plan for you. Therefore, people of God, I am coming against the enemy, attacking your star in Jesus' name. God knows, God has big plan for you. And the devil knows that God has a big plan for you. So he will try to use witches, try to use wizards, try to use occult, try to use false prophet, try to use false pastor, false apostles to attack and damage your star. Therefore, people of God, I am standing before the presence of God, before God, to pray for you, to pray for you. Every star that has been attacked by wizard, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. I am stopping them by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, God, thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus, my God and my Father. I want to bless your name. I want to thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be the name of Jesus. My Father, I thank you. If your life, it has experienced troubles and battles, it is a sign that you have a shining star. If your life has been experienced troubles and battles, it is a sign that you have a shining star. You have been identified, and you must defend your precious star with aggression and with all your knowledge and everything to defend your star in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus. A man strong man enemy is a man that is attacking your star. An enemy that is attacking your star is a great enemy. That is a strong man. We call it a strong man that is attacking your star. Therefore, every strong man attacking your star from signing, let them cut fire. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Your Goliath depends on where you are going. So if your Goliath's problem is so numerous and huge, preciously, you know, Goliath, he studied the star of David. No, Goliath did not study the star of David. He didn't. Now, he thought that he is able to destroy all the Israel, including David. He didn't study the star of David. He didn't know. Otherwise, if he knew that David was a star, they could have do everything to silence him. They didn't identify David. They tried, but they were not able to identify, to find him. Moses, they saw the star of Moses. Now they saw this Moses is coming to deliver the children of Israel. They will kill the children. They saw the star of Moses when Moses was born. They tried to kill him, but they didn't kill him. Enemy that want to kill your star, let them die, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. They attacked the star of Daniel. You know Daniel in the Bible, they attacked the star. They wanted to silence him. They wanted to kill him. When they said that, oh king, everybody must worship you. Daniel said, I'm not going to worship any idols. I know if I die, I will go to heaven, rather to go to hellfire. So they said they are going to throw Daniel in the lion, in the den of a lion, so that the lion can eat him. The lion did not touch Daniel because Daniel was also a lion like them. Now, the enemy that wants to attack your star shall die and be destroyed in Jesus' name. When the brothers of Joseph had the dream Joseph told them, They realized that his star is signing, and they wanted to do everything to silence him and to kill him and destroy him so that his star cannot shine. But they didn't kill him. That is it. Oh, enemies, who is planning to destroy your star? He has not killed you. Your star will shine. The enemy that will kill you is the enemy that you will fear. But as long as they have not killed you, you are still alive. You can restore your star back in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Daniel was an exile in a foreign land. Despite all his unfortunate situation and comfortable situation, he retained focus on God. His star was attacked so hard. We see him, how he was thrown in the den of Eden to be eaten, but God delivered him. We see Moses, how he was attacked, how his star was attacked so hard, until his sisters, they had to throw him in the sea, in the lake, in the river, so that his star cannot be destroyed. In the name of Jesus Christ, they tried to kill him by killing male children born at that time. We have seen Joseph. We have seen Joseph, his own brothers were envying him, and they wanted to attack the star. And Joseph was thrown to the prison, and all in all, his star was still shining. They didn't destroy him. We see David. He was nobody in the jungle until his advancement. The place attacked David the star, several positions from his household, and even the innumerable and incapable, even the king tried to kill him. King Saul tried to kill him because they saw his star, but they didn't kill him. Hallelujah. Jesus, we have seen the Jesus, how they tried to kill him because of his star, but they didn't kill him. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray every rage of darkness against your shining star, scatter in the name of Jesus. I command them to scatter, to scatter, to scatter, to scatter, to scatter in the name of Jesus. Every rage of darkness assigned against your shining star, let them scatter, let them be destroyed, let them be rendered powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, every enemy following your star, every enemy attacking your star from shining, let them scatter. Let them scatter, let them scatter, let them scatter, scatter in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I praise your name, God. Let your star, let your right so shine before men that you may see the glory of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Arise, shine, for the right has come, and the glory of the Lord is arisen in Jesus' name. God has created us to manifest his glory as we are created in his image of God. We do not just me exist. God has loaded us with blessings and potential. We are not shining as we ought to be. There is a problem somewhere, somehow. Yes, there is a problem. We are not signing. We are not signing like the way God has created us. Something is there is a problem somewhere, somehow. We need to sign. We need to sign. We need to sign. We need to sign. We need to sign by fire, by thunder in Jesus' name. If you are not signing, you have to sign by fire. You have to sign in Jesus' name. You have to sign. Kill the star. It is possible to kill a star of infant, and the person will not even seem to ever sign at in life. You know, when they kill the star of infant, the infant will never sign anymore. The infant will die, will leave his star will be in him, but is dead. They have killed his star. The person can be useless. The person who was a star, who was mountain move, who was a powerful. Now they kill his star. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, I destroy and bind out every enemy that is attacking your star in Jesus' name. Every of your star that has been killed, I command the fire and the thunder of God to receive it, to receive in Jesus' name. I command them to come live. Everyone that their star has been killed, I command them to come live in Jesus' name. Let your star come live. 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 Hashtag stars. Attack a star. A star can be identified and sized if not guided appropriately with the prayers. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus. Enemy that is attacking your star. Enemy that is attacking your star. Enemy that is stealing your star. I command the enemy to return your star. To return your star and die. To return your star and die. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. I want to thank you, Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. If your star has been exchanged, I command divine restoration back in the name of Jesus. If your star has been exchanged, I command divine restoration back in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, star can be gauged. Enemy can gauge your star. When a star is engaged, people will see that the person has a pride destiny, but he has nowhere. If your star is being engaged, your star can be caged. When your star is gauged, is people will see that the person has a pride destiny, but no one or other the person would be able to break forth. It could make it to make the star shine, to make it the star shine, the star has been gauged. You know, when your star has been gauged, the people will see you like you are nobody, because your star is being engaged. You have ideas, you reason, but since your star is being engaged, nobody can recognize you. You talk well, you speak very good English, you speak very good language, you have very good voice, you have everything, you can sing like angel, like the way Lucifer was singing in heaven, but because your star has been engaged, you can't sing anywhere. Your voice cannot be heard anywhere. Even if you cry, even if you talk, nobody will listen to you. Nobody, because your star has been engaged. Therefore, people of God, I pray your star that has been engaged, come out and shine in the name of Jesus. Your star that has been engaged, come out, come out, come out, come out. Come out, come out, come out, come out in the name of Jesus. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. I want to thank you. Thank you so much for coming. God will help you in Jesus' name. Come, I pray that God will help you. And share this video. Share to your friends. Facebook. Twitter, God will help you. Tomorrow I'm coming back 9 a.m. And today we have our deliverance prayer. So those people who are living around here, you are most welcome. You can come and join us. Our prayer meeting tonight at 7 p.m. So tomorrow we are on. Tomorrow we have deliverance at 12 noon. We have deliverance 12 noon. So those people who are following me in Periscope, in Popcorn and Prayer Line, they have information, and we are fasting. We are on fasting. So if you want to participate, you have to participate through Prayer Line and Popcorn. We don't do it in Periscope. You can see a lot of destruction in Periscope, so we don't do it in Periscope. And also, we are taking our first fruit offering. If you have not give your first fruit offering, you can give your first fruit offering at PayPal. You can go to your PayPal account and write our email address, overcomersdhm@gmail.com, and you can give your first fruit very easily and very within 2 minutes you have done. You can give also your tithe through our Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry on your PayPal. Also, you can donate an amount if this ministry is blessing you. And if this is your ministry, you will donate an amount, support the work of God through us, and God will help you. I will pray for you. God help you. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye, bye-bye, bye-bye once again. Remember to call. The number is 905-792-3798. God will help you in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow, 9 a.m. God will bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you.